Hi guys, I'm Irina. Happy Feast! In this video, I ask some of the people who live in Egypt to talk about feast, what it means for them, what feelings they have about it. Let's see what they got. Watch till the end. You may see the people you know. Have fun!
Eid has always been a lovely occasion, as we usually buy new clothes and spend it with our families. On the last day of Ramadan, we start by baking some biscuits and kahk. My grandmother usually helps us with the recipe. They always turn out to be fantastic and yummy. After iftar, we call all of our friends to say Eid Mubarak. Then we stay all night laughing and playing cards until Eid prayer. We usually spend the first day of Eid by going to the cinema to watch a movie or having lunch at any restaurant. Eid is full of hilarious situations and memories with my cousins. This year Eid will be a bit different, as we will not be able to go out. But we will still bake and have a small family gathering at home. I wish you all Eid Mubarak.
Finally, it's feast, or Eid al-Fitr, which we break our fasting after the holy month of Ramadan. There are lots of traditions in a feast, which are visiting our relatives and grandparents, but nowadays it's coronavirus, which we can't go anywhere. So we are talking to our grandparents online. We used to have adaya, which is money we take from our relatives and grandparents, but nowadays we can't. I don't know how. And but the only thing that will not change it's eating kahk or cookies, but please don't eat too much. Happy Eid!
This is one of the most important days of the year. You get to spend time with your family and have fun. And your family can tell you tricks or can tell you jokes. You get to spend time, you eat at the biggest table, and you get to have fun. And also, you are going to have a lovely day in the feast.
Hello, happy feast. I would like to talk about our traditions in the feast as Egyptians. We have special traditions like eating kahk. Eating kahk is something very unique that makes us different than many other countries, any other Muslim countries. We like eating kahk in the first day of Eid in the morning. The kahk is a nice sweet. We all love it, kids and adults. We give kids adaya. Adaya is amount of money which is given to the kids in the morning, in the first day of Eid. And they, of course, they feel very happy. We use to meet our relatives, but because of the quarantine, we cannot meet them this year. We of course wear new clothes as Muslims and Egyptians. Happy feast, and I hope everyone enjoy it. Thank you.
For an Egyptian female like myself, Eid is not only about kahk. It's about working really hard for 7 days or maybe more before Eid, cleaning up every inch in the house, getting ready for visitors that we may never receive, wearing new clothes, including pajamas, receiving adaya, which is the money that we get from our parents, grandparents, uncles and aunts. Of course, having falafel for breakfast after Eid prayers, which is something that we do in Alexandria, as we do not have falafel during Ramadan in Alexandria, so we start having falafel in Eid. And of course the warm, loud and crowded family gatherings that I really miss, and I hope that we can have again soon. That's it for me.
Hello, I'm Mark. Today I will share with you our Egyptian habits to celebrate the Eid. One of the things that make the Eid a special occasion to everyone, that we meet our relatives and eat a special biscuit named kahk. Also play football and video games till the sun rises. And after that, my Muslim friend go to the mosque and pray the Eid. This year, unfortunately, the mosques are closed due to the coronavirus. At the end, happy Eid to everyone and everywhere.
Hello everyone, I'm Habiba. I came here to talk about the feast. Actually,
But this year is going to be different than any other year, especially in the feast celebration because of the covenanting and the quarantine. Let's start with the memories we make or the habits we have, like going to pray in the mosque early in the morning, with our family, with our relatives, with our friends, with our neighbors, with everyone we cherish and with everyone we love. Normally, or my family in particular, we gather at my grandparents' house. We go to eat together to make new and fun memories together. And it actually, I cherish it so much, and it's super amazing, super interesting. I love it so much. But this feast, we're not going to be able to do this because the gathering is not allowed. The social distancing and all of those stuff. So I think the feast this year is going to be super boring and super dull, but I wish all the best to all of you and wish that everybody's safe and thank you.
Hello guys, today I'm going to talk to you about feast. Feast come after the holy month of Ramadan, after fasting it to purify our souls and try to get closer to God through our good and charitable deeds. It means a lot to me, as it is full of joy and, of course, saideya. I have a great memories related to feast, as our traditions that we must buy new clothes, have a nice good shower, have a family gathering to have lunch together at grandpa's house. We all have a great family time and also collect saideya from uncles and elder people. Feast will be different this year, unfortunately, as we will spend more time with our families, which I call a quality time. And although this pandemic virus affects us all negatively, but it forces us to get closer together and get closer to our families, understand each other more, care more, and of course laugh and love each other more. Okay. That's all, folks, and happy feast to you and your all beautiful family. Stay safe, stay united, and love each other more. Thank you.
Happy feast for everyone. As a mother, my memories was to buying clothes for my children, buying the kahk and the petit four for the children, because I don't know how to make it, of course, so I prefer to buy it ready-made. The most important thing for me, the feast prayer, hearing the imam and el takbirat of the feast.
I remember one time I went out with my family and I got lost, and hopefully someone found me and told me to call them from his phone, and I returned safely. So people at this time are always happy and everybody celebrates Eid al-Fitr.
Eid means for me many things. Actually, it starts about 7 days before Eid, when I start to make kak and petit fours, biscuits, making sure every day I do some so I don't leave it to the last minute. I perhaps don't do as much now as I used to when my kids were at home, but it was one of our main things. 7 days before Eid, they would come to the kitchen and start to help me get ready for Eid. Of course, then it's cleaning the house and buying clothes for the kids. And actually, I used to always buy myself something too. Then, of course, on the day of Eid, the kids always used to be dying to wear their clothes, and we would usually go and pray, come back and have some of our delicious biscuits. But Eid is also a spiritual time, and it's the time when Allah rewards you for all the good things that you've done throughout the year. So it's a very precious time for us all.
Muslims celebrate a ceremony which comes after Ramadan called feast. We have a lot of traditional habits in our Egyptian society, such as Egyptians usually wear new clothes, eat many kinds of biscuits, and visit their parents and relatives. Children usually play with fireworks, which make a grateful shape in the sky. Old people usually give young children money to see a great happiness on their faces.
Well, the feast for me is considered a pure source of happiness, actually for two main reasons. The first one is the prayers. Since I was a kid until now, I used to prepare my abaya and didn't get enough sleep to wait Salat al-Eid or the prayers after al-Fajr and so on, and to leave the house early enough to catch a good place in the mosque. So this is something amazing. The second one is to bake kahk with my mom, but this when I was a kid, of course, but nowadays we just buy it and so on.
That's it for today. Thank you for watching. See you soon. Bye.